This is a story about progress. A few years ago, Nicaragua, like many other developing countries in the world, had a problem. Scores of children were dying from a preventable illness called rotavirus, an infection that is the most common cause of severe diarrhea. There were so many cases, many hospitals had to place two children to each crib. They knew they had to do something.
Nicaragua came to us and to other partners and said, we want to take on this disease.
In 2006, PATH, a global nonprofit, along with several public health partners, helped Nicaragua gain access to the rotavirus vaccine. The country began a massive vaccination program.
And within a two-year period, we saw a dramatic reduction in the number of children who are hospitalized and suffering from the severe forms of rotavirus infection.
Today, more than 80% of newborns in Nicaragua are vaccinated for rotavirus, making cases like Wilson's, a two-year-old boy suffering from severe diarrhea, less and less common. His arms and legs are tied to prevent him from pulling out the tubes needed to rehydrate him and save his life. As uncomfortable as this looks, Wilson is one of the lucky ones. He received the care he needed and recovered. Today in Nicaragua, vaccines that prevent such severe infections have left hospital wards that were once overcrowded with children now virtually empty. Unfortunately, despite their effectiveness, rotavirus vaccines are not available in most of the developing world. With the support of global donors, we can replicate the success of Nicaragua everywhere. But until we get the vaccines to everyone who needs them, rotavirus remains a global health crisis, one of the biggest threats children in the developing world face. Worldwide, rotavirus is responsible for millions of hospitalizations and ultimately kills over 500,000 children each year. It's contagious, and almost every child will have it before their third birthday.
In industrialized, rich countries such as the United States and Europe, these are a manageable disease. But for children living in remote parts of poor countries in Africa, in Asia, and in Latin America, rotavirus is a death sentence.
As a doctor, I see 5 to 10 children dying a day from rotavirus infection.
Surprisingly, unlike other diarrheal diseases, rotavirus cannot be prevented with traditional measures like cleaning up water and improving sanitation. Vaccines are the only way to prevent severe rotavirus. Once a child becomes ill, rotavirus can be treated with oral rehydration therapy and zinc. But that's not an option for many who live far from medical care or for those who reach care too late. In an environment like this, vaccines should be the first line of defense against disease. For many, including Evelyn, a mother in Kenya, getting vaccinated means the difference between life and death.
My son Abel started getting sick. I was worried and went to the health clinic. I sat down and waited. Abel looked drawn. He was getting sicker. I never even saw a doctor. The next day, my son Abel died.
He never received a rotavirus vaccine that could have protected him. This same vaccine reduced childhood hospitalizations for severe rotavirus by nearly 80% after just 1 year of use in the U.S. But it is not yet widely used in Africa and Asia, where most rotavirus deaths occur, because developing countries can't afford the vaccines. But now that's changing, and real progress is being made. Recently, the World Health Organization recommended that every country include the rotavirus vaccine in their national immunization program, which led the Gavi Alliance, a public-private partnership of healthcare organizations, governments, and donors, to provide developing countries with the financial support they need to get the rotavirus vaccine.
Of all the public health interventions, immunization is the most cost-effective.
We need to bring global donors and national governments together in order to deliver these new life-saving vaccines to the children who need them most.
A child in Mali may be malnourished, may not have access to clean water, may be miles away from the hospital. That child's only chance is this vaccine. Our job is to get it to them.
But Gavi can't do it alone. It will take commitments from donors, policymakers, and the developed world to continue the momentum to help provide the necessary funding so all countries have access to these life-saving vaccines.
We've tested this vaccine in Africa and Asia. WHO recommends it. Governments are ready to introduce it. Let's do it.
We did it in Nicaragua. We can do it everywhere and give all children a fair chance, because no child should die from diarrhea. Visit defeatdd.org to find out how you can help.